Hey guys, it's Corey with 10 Best Ones. And today we've decided to review the 5 best options for you. If you'd like to see their price and find out more information, you can check out the links in the description down below. Let's get started. If you're looking for a compact model, then this next option is what you're looking for.
Number 5, Lenovo Chromebook Duet. Chromebooks have become one of the most attractive laptops out there since they provide great functionality with a simple interface and a low price that boosts the value of the device. They also are pretty compact in the majority of cases, and if you're looking for such a laptop, I suggest the Lenovo Chromebook Duet. This is a great 2-in-1 that comes with a nice keyboard, great battery life, sharp panel, and it's still pretty affordable overall. Great Chrome OS optimization as well, well worth investing in. So, let's check it out. The Lenovo Chromebook Duet is a great all-in-one package which on its own is just a tablet, with a two-tone color on the back and the simple Chrome logo right there. It also has an 8-megapixel camera on there. I should also mention that the tablet itself is a fingerprint magnet, so for that reason I would keep the kickstand cover to protect it from smudges. Contrary to the tablet itself, the kickstand cover gives it a more professional feeling to the device, and I'm quite impressed with it. Combined with a dark grey keyboard that snaps on as well, you've got yourself a pretty professional device. The whole thing weighs about £2 in total and measures about 0.7 inches at its thickest with a kickback stand and keyboard cover. The Lenovo Chromebook Duet rocks a 10.2-inch 1920x1200 panel that surprisingly grants you plenty of colour for the price it comes at. The bezels around the screen are a bit thick though, but I think it's reasonable at the budget the Lenovo Chromebook Duet comes at. The panel of this Chromebook reached 106% of the sRGB color space, which is the best in its category. The accuracy was top-notch as well, with a delta E of 0.2, without forgetting I should mention the 372-nit brightness was near perfect. The keyboard might be a bit cramped overall, but it's good at this compact package. The touchpad on it was solid as well, and it supports all Chromebook gestures. The Lenovo Chromebook Duet is equipped with a MediaTek Helio P60T CPU that combines the 4GB of LPDDR4X RAM to produce speed and snappiness. It also has 64GB of SSD and an integrated ARM G72 MP3 graphics unit to present a smooth overall performance. Worth investing in.
Battery life is extremely important. This next model has the best battery life out of the bunch.
Number 4. Google Pixelbook. Moving on, the next entry in our list is a high-end Chromebook, the Google Pixelbook. This beast has the best battery life in the category, is packed with some seriously powerful specs even for a normal laptop, great display, great keyboard, stylus support, and so much more. Without forgetting the Chrome OS experience, which is much better than everything else you might have seen out there. Right from the get-go, you'll see that the Google Pixelbook is a pretty high-end device with a near-perfect design. Everything is very cleverly thought out and nothing is an afterthought. It has a flawless brushed aluminium body all around except the rubberized palm rest. Everything is just beautiful with it. It has the same minimal vibes of the Google Pixel smartphone series with a simple but attractive design. The whole thing is pretty thin overall as well, measuring about 0.44 inches at its thickest, and it's quite portable as it weighs just 2.5 pounds in total. Without forgetting, I should state that it's extremely durable thanks to the excellent build quality. The Google Pixelbook is packed with a 12.3-inch touchscreen panel up front with a nice 2400x1600 resolution with an amazing 235 pixel per inch density for sharpness. Moving on, it also managed to reproduce about 117% of the sRGB color space with great accuracy, delivering a capable experience. The brightness peaks at 420 nits, which is great. Nothing to complain about the design of this one. The keyboard of this compact laptop was great as well, with a nice 0.9mm key travel. The overall typing experience was solid, with 68 grams of actuation force. Right in the middle of the rubberized palm rest, you'll spot the 4x2.6-inch edge-to-edge glass touchpad, which was pretty pleasing to use. In the performance department, the Google Pixelbook is packed with some interesting specs, namely the 7th generation Intel Core i5-7Y57 CPU and 8GB of RAM, which renders a rather smooth experience. Moving on, it also has 128GB of SSD, which is pretty fast in its own right. Without forgetting, I should state that the battery life of the beast is at 12 hours with normal use, so you'll have plenty of fun with this one.
If you're looking for a mid-range model, then this next pick is a great option.
Number 3. Asus Chromebook Flip C434. As I said earlier, Chromebooks were not always an attractive option for productivity users, but lately they're the perfect option. If you want a great mid-range model, you should take a look at the Asus Chromebook Flip C434, which is one of the most attractive choices out there, providing performance, battery life, nice display, and two-in-one functionality. Let's take a closer look at it. First off, I should state that the Asus Chromebook Flip C434 comes in different configurations you can choose from, but today we're going to take a look at the best, at least in my opinion. The option with the Intel Core M3-8100Y CPU with 8GB of RAM and 64GB of eMMC storage that's capable of handling all your productivity tasks. The whole thing also has two USB Type-C ports that makes it future-proof, and a USB Type-A port, so just excellent overall with no weak points so far. Just by looking at the Asus Chromebook Flip C434, you would think that it comes from a more premium range of Asus laptops. It has all the tricks and details to make it look like a premium device, with its matte silver aluminium finish and the chrome trim details. On the front of the device, you'll notice the bezels are so thin, and the whole build quality of the Asus Chromebook Flip C434 is amazing overall. The hinges are super smooth as well, and allow you to use it in tablet mode. The display in the front is pretty good as well, with its 14-inch touchscreen Full HD resolution 4-way Nano Edge display that gives a beautiful experience. It also has a great color reproduction besides its amazing sharpness. It managed to reproduce about 93% of the sRGB color space with a nice accuracy rating. The brightness is about 290 nits at max, and the viewing angles are pretty good, which translates to a great overall experience. The performance specs that we talked about earlier might not look like much, but thanks to the great Chrome OS optimization, it manages a pretty smooth experience that you wouldn't expect at this price point. Productivity and multitasking at the same time. I should mention the touchscreen responsiveness, which was better than most, and the 10-hour battery life is perfect overall when it comes to Chromebooks.
Before we talk about the best model overall, let's look at the runner-up for this list.
Number 2. Acer Chromebook Spin 13CP713. If you're shopping for a great mid-range Chromebook, you should take a look at this one, the Acer Chromebook Spin 13CP713. I can comfortably say that Acer knows how to provide the best value laptops, and this Chromebook seems to fit the bill. Besides that, it delivers great performance, a nice display, tons of other features, so it's well worth your money. So, without further ado, let's take a closer look. The first thing I have to state about the Acer Chromebook Spin 13CP713 is that it is a bit large for a 13-inch laptop with its 3:2 aspect ratio. However, this doesn't affect its portability, as it's pretty thin and you can pack it in your backpack without any problem. It also has a pretty premium build quality and design. For example, it has Corning's Gorilla Glass on its touchscreen panel and its touchpad. There are diamond-cut edges on its anodized aluminium body that give it a beautiful look as well. I can comfortably say that it's a very well-designed device. In the right side of the device, you'll spot the status light, the volume rocker, the power button, and a USB Type-C spot. The other side has a 3.5mm port, micro SD card slot, USB 3.0, and another USB Type-C port to complete the package. Without forgetting about it, I should state that on the right side, under the palm rest, you'll see the Wacom pen. The Acer Chromebook Spin 13CP713 is packed with a 13.5-inch in-plane switching panel with a nice 2256x1504 resolution that delivers sharpness and a great viewing experience overall thanks to its great viewing angles. The contrast was solid at 1500:1 natively, and it reaches a solid 370 nits of brightness at peak. The color reproduction and accuracy is great for the price that it comes at, just amazing. The power and performance of the Acer Chromebook Spin 13CP713 comes from the 8th generation Intel Core i5-5250U processor, which is pretty fast, thanks to its hyper-thread cores that grant a turbo clock speed of 3.4 GHz. I should mention that it also provides about 128GB of SSD and 8GB of RAM to speed things up. One of the best ones out there, without a doubt.
Finally, the next model is the best overall. From us, it gets a perfect score in all categories.
Number 1. Google Pixelbook Go. Coming to the top of the list, we have the Google Pixelbook Go, which is the value-based version of the Pixelbook I was talking about a few entries ago. And while it isn't as advanced as the other one, it gives some excellent performance with a beautiful design, great battery life, and a great keyboard. Let's check it out. The Google Pixelbook Go is designed to be light and small, and I can comfortably say that it is extremely portable, with its 0.5-inch thick body and its superlight 2.3-pound weight. The Google Pixelbook Go comes in two different attractive colors, just black and not pink, both of which are very aesthetically pleasing. The frame of this beast is made of magnesium alloy with a matte texture that's paired with a rippled base to allow you to grip it better. The whole frame is very resistant to flex and pressure. In terms of connectivity, you'll see two USB Type-C ports and a 3.5mm audio port. The 13.3-inch touchscreen panel of the Google Pixel Book Go is super attractive as well, with 1920 by 1080p full HD sharpness and its amazing colours and brightness. I should note that the panel can reproduce about 108% of the sRGB colour space with great accuracy and 370 nits of brightness, which is better than most out there. The touchpad and the keyboard are great, especially the hush keys that are installed that, as their name implies, are extremely quiet. The performance and production prowess of the Google Pixel Book Go were pretty good as well, thanks to the 8th generation Intel Core i5-8200Y processor with 8GB of RAM that makes it capable of shredding through everything you may put it through. It also has 128GB of SSD that's pretty good for its price. The Intel UHD 615 graphics unit is pretty good as well, and in benchmark tests, it proved itself without any problem. Buying guide. Firstly, portability. The most important thing you have to check out when you're buying a Chromebook is the portability, since most of these are designed to be productivity devices that you can carry around. For that reason, you should check out its size and weight. Then again, most of the time, these devices are pretty slim and lightweight, so it wouldn't be much of a problem, especially if you stick with the options I suggested in this list. Secondly, battery life. Another thing that works great with the productivity is the aspect of battery life. This is an especially important feature that you need to consider if you're a person that's out and about and needs a laptop that will allow you to be productive on the go. All the devices that are in this list are providing great battery life, some better than others, but generally it's pretty respectable. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.